Hey guys, it's Sam. Today I have a review for you with my Canon selfie. I would like to say just before I get started that this is not a sponsored review in any way, and Canon didn't send this to me, and this is not anything but my personal honest opinions about photographs. And in my search to find printers for my photographs, I had lots of different recommendations. If you've seen my other videos, you know that I have had trouble finding something that I was really happy with. I did in the end land with a Canon Ivy, and I really love that. Someone had mentioned that they thought that the picture wasn't very good and that it looked green on the screen and that I must have been paid for a review, but I assure you that that did not happen. And in person, it looks very true to color. It is true that none of those pocket printers look the same as if you were like going to have a photo printed for you, and that's not their purpose. Their purpose is to be fun little pictures that you can print out and peel off a sticker for and have in your planner or whatever you want in your life. So they are definitely not supposed to be professional quality, but they are supposed to be something that's fun. That being said, I still wanted the best of the group, and those that I have shared with you in the last few weeks didn't meet my expectations for quality. However, the Canon did. So that's the one that I'm keeping. That's the one I'm going to be using. That all being said, the selfie was something that was suggested to me, and initially I was very afraid of it. If you look at the difference, you have this little tiny pocket printer, and then you have this big one. It has to be plugged in to the wall to work. You have to have different kinds of things to keep it going. With the Canon Ivy, all you have to do is put these little tiny pieces of paper in it, have it charged, and you're ready to go. This, you have to use the ink that comes with it, and you have to attach the paper. So I was kind of afraid of all of that, but I was thankfully convinced to go ahead and give it a try by many of you, and I'm really glad that I did, because I'm really happy with the quality of the pictures that the selfie gives. So I'm just gonna kind of give you a quick overview of what you have when you get the selfie. So you have the machine itself, and then you have the cord to plug it in, and it's in two pieces. One piece goes into the selfie itself, and then the other piece goes into the wall charger, and you connect the two, you plug it in, and you turn it on. So when you first get it, you do have to set it up. So I have it set to a direct connection, and that means that when I use my iPad to print a picture, I have it connected. Like, this is no longer connected to my home Wi-Fi, so I could not like go onto YouTube and watch a video right now. It's connected to the selfie. So they're gonna talk to each other from this point. The app that I suggest is the selfie app. There are different apps that you can use, but the selfie app gives you some more interesting things to do, like a bookmark that I printed for my Hobonichi weeks. It prints two at a time, which I think I'll show you here. And I think that that's something that's really cool. You can do like different layouts, and it just gives you a little bit more freedom to be artistic with your photos. So when you first get it, it does come with a trial cartridge, and I think that gives you 10 pictures. And then you have the tray that your paper goes in, and let me see where we are here. Okay, so you load the paper into the tray, and then you pop the first piece up. So you have to pop both pieces of plastic to get your papers in, but then when it's in use, you open this, you pop the tray inside, and then this becomes like your catch tray. And so the paper feeds backwards through here, and then it prints out your finished product into the tray here. I did purchase the extra package, and I got it yesterday. So I was kind of waiting for this to come before I tried a video because I was afraid I was going to run out. So it is like a large box. It's filled with different packs of paper and different cartridges of ink. So for $30, you get 108 sheets. And so if you have more than one picture, you're, you know, only then saving more money from there. But for $30 for 108 sticker, for 108 sheets, that's definitely better cost-wise than your little pocket printers. This is not sticker paper. You can get sticker paper for these, but I kind of wanted to use this in a different way. I'm gonna stick to the little photos for putting in my Hobonichi, and I'm gonna use the selfie for kind of other things. So I have these on hand in case we need them while I'm printing here. So like I said, the selfie is connected to my iPad, and I'm gonna go ahead and print a photo so that you can see what to expect. I think I'm gonna go ahead and just make another bookmark. So I had shared on Instagram earlier this week and people were really excited, like, how did you make that? But it does it all for you, if you can see. So you just select the photos and then you know, they go in and then you print them out, and there's even the line here to show you where to cut. So this is where you would choose the kind of paper that you're using. This is the bigger paper, this is the little label paper. You can choose if you have a border, dot grid, background, and things like that. I'm not gonna fool with all of that, but I am gonna go ahead and select my photos. Okay, so unfortunately, my iPad is not playing along with me today, and so I'm gonna have to switch and record on my iPad and print from my phone. So I had to get all of that changed up. So where I was the bookmark layout and selecting photos. And for whatever reason, my iPad doesn't want to do that for me today. But I'm just gonna go through and pick the same photos that I used the other day. All right, so it brings up this layout. Now, you cannot change the photos. So whatever is on the first bookmark is going to be on the second. So you can't make it like two unique bookmarks that are not like each other. So then you hit print preview, and it reminds you that if you want it to look like this, that when you're in this screen, you need to make sure that it's set to borderless, and then you hit print. So it is a little more loud, and it does take a little longer than the little mini ones, but it actually like puts the color on for you in stages. So it goes through the whole process. And I can't get this any higher up because my iPad is heavier on my mount than my phone is. So I'm just gonna move it back and forth for you. And then the last process that it goes through after all of the colors is a protective coating. And it's glossy, but there is a setting that you can hit to kind of like make it have like a pretend matte finish. And that one's a little louder and it takes a little longer. I had that set, I actually first got a black one and then I went and exchanged it for a white one because I liked that one better. So let me see. I think it's down here in the setup. And then right here. So set automatically to glossy, and I put it on pattern 3. So I'm gonna go back in and have it set to that, and then I'm gonna just print something else. It's reminding me that this is gonna all be cleared out if I do that. I'm gonna choose a shuffle layout. 8 photos, 20, oh that's a lot. Do a landscape orientation.
I wish that you could kind of choose different because of like how many kids we have. I'd like for them all to have like the same size. Does that make sense? Like the same size box. So let's see. One, two, three, four, five, six. And then I'll choose seven and then eight. See, I don't like that. I'm gonna change the landscape back to portrait. I would really like if I could just like drag that one up. That is better because then the family is on a bigger one and the kids are all in smaller frames so that like nobody is in like a better place in the photo. So I'm gonna go ahead and print that. Maybe I'll just leave it here for this one. And then the last is going to be that louder. It's also slower to give you the matte finish. It's not an actual matte finish, it's like a pretend. Like, I don't know what it does, something in there. And it makes like bumps and stuff. And then you can touch this as soon as it comes out because that coating is on there. It's like I can see it, but there would be no way I don't think that you can see it. It still looks glossy, but it's not as shiny. And if you get like really close there, let me see. There's like bumps. There's bumps in there. Anyway, so I think that this is a super cool little machine. And then you just take off the edges. I'm not sure really what those edges like do in the process, but I think that it makes a really great final result. And so with this one, you take it off, and then there's this line here, and you can either use like your cutter or scissors because the line is there for you otherwise. And then this would make like a really good gift if you have a reader in your life and you want them to have like a different kind of picture other than just like a picture that you would put like on your fridge or in a frame, you know, do what I did and make a little label. For my Hobonichi, I made one and I just printed out family. On my little Dymo Letcher tag, and I put one for me and one for my husband, and we are using them in our planners. I do have everything that you need for the printer in my Amazon shop, which I will link below. I've only had it since Monday. So I haven't had a chance to play around with it too much because it didn't come with many papers. But now that I have my pack here, I'll be able to print to my heart's desire. when you are storing it, when you're done, you pull it out of the machine and then you close it up so that it doesn't like get dust on it or anything. And then I just have it plugged in permanently at my desk and just like right there for me to pull away. And then I just kind of store it with this in between my washi tape drawers so that it's tucked away and, you know, doesn't get messed with by anybody. So this would definitely be, if you have no need for sticker paper, then this would definitely have the best color result of all the photo printers that I tried. This is the HP that has a more orange quality. The Canon definitely is better than the others that I've tried, but the selfie wins over the Ivy for sure. But for me, like I said earlier, they have a different purpose. But if you only were going to choose one and you wanted to have the best possible result of a photo and you don't mind like putting glue strips or whatever you want to use to hold things down, washi tape, whatever, if you don't mind that in whatever you're using, I would definitely go with a selfie. The printer alone is $100. So you're going to be spending like $130 to get the printer, if it's on sale, of course, and the papers that go with it. But like I said, it's going to get you 108 photos, and so you're not going to be replacing it all the time. And if, like I said earlier, if you like split that 4x6 up into many different pictures, you're actually getting a lot more for your money than you could with one of the mini printers. If you have any questions about the selfie, I'll do my best to answer them for you. This is the newest model, the CP1300, and like I said before, I definitely recommend the selfie app because there's like three other Canon apps that you can use, but I have found that one to be the most useful for making different things other than just like printing out a standard photo. If you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you again soon.